About a week ago, Big Clive put out a video about a traffic warning flashing light thing. And that reminded me that I've got one, but it's a completely different type. So I figured I'd pop it out of my closet and open it up and take a look at it, just to see how different it is inside as well. From the outside, this one looks quite a bit different. It has a much larger lens on it. And it is only really visible from two sides. It's a big flat lens. And also the battery box on the bottom is bigger. This one takes two of the 6-volt lantern batteries. This type of battery, the 6-volt with two spring terminals, they go into the base of here. I can't remember if they're in series or parallel. It's been a while since I've looked inside this thing previously, so we'll take a look at that in a minute. This particular one is manufactured by the Emco Light Company. This is model number 100 from Elgin, Illinois. It's so old that they only have their telephone number on here in 7 digits and not the 10 digits that it would be normally. Anyway, this particular one I modified years and years ago just to put a plug pack on it so I could run it without the surprisingly expensive batteries. And this plug pack is, what is it? Oh, it's a 6-volt plug pack. Okay, so that suggests to me that the two batteries are in parallel for extended life. Right. Now, normally there is a bolt that goes in here into the captive nut on there so you can attach it to signage or whatever. Obviously, that's long gone from this one. And then up inside here, we have the metallic strips that the batteries go onto, and again you can see that there has been some corrosion on here and it's been scraped at in the past. There's a few other interesting things about this, but first let's just get the electronic module out of here. It just pulls out that easily. It's just wedged in there and held in by the springs and the batteries. So now I can get this stuff out of the way. So first off, we'll look at the bulb here. It's just a simple little DC bulb. W1895 for the light bulb aficionados in the crowd. You know who you are. I know I'm one too. So that just bayonets onto there. Then we have a little push button here, which turns it on and off. And that is accessed through this little hole in the case. So the entire thing is fairly well weatherproofed, except for that one little hole right there, weirdly. Behind that switch, there is a little cadmium sulfide type photoresistor, so that this thing only runs when it's dark outside. I think I can shield that from the light enough to make it flash on the workbench. That's why I had the lights dimmed at the beginning when I was pouring the beer, because it wouldn't stay on in the bright lighting that I've got going on around here. There we go. So now that it thinks that it's dark in here, we can see what it's actually doing. And then if I hit the switch, of course, it shuts it off. Fairly straightforward little device so far. Let's dive deeper and get to the circuit board. So this little enclosure is held together with a couple of clips. Two on that side and one on this side. I think I'll just pry this one. I think that's the move. Let's try an actual spudger in here. There we go. So there's where the wires are soldered onto the battery terminals, including the wires that I added. And then down in there, we can see a little circuit board. And I think I'm going to have to unscrew the knob off there, off the switch. And, oh no, I don't. I can get that up out of here. Okay. Yeah, I didn't have to do that. And that gets us a view of the epoxy gooped circuit board. What do we have in here? It's not even much of a circuit board. Is it even a PCB or is it just point to point on there? So we have this wire and this wire coming from the photocell. The red wire and that black wire are coming from the batteries. And that wire is going up to the lamp holder. And then the lamp holder has a red wire coming down and going to the negative right. Okay, whatever. Color codes are irrelevant. And looking into there, I don't see any traces on that board at all. Though I do see some discoloration there, which looks to me like weathered copper. No, it doesn't scrape off. So maybe that's just a tag board with just a board with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 rivets through it, and then everything is just soldered to those, all point to point kind of. Well, that's all nice and vintage. I don't know if I'm going to be able to get this resin potting compound off there, but I can see that there's one transistor there. There's another one here. We have one capacitor and four resistors. So that is likely to be just a simple little flip-flop kind of a circuit. It looks like with enough poking and prodding and mild amounts of violence, I can actually get some of this potting compound off here. I'm not sure if it is an actual resin or something else. It's both hard but soft, weirdly. I can dig a tool into it, but then it flakes off in chunks. So I'm going to spend some time abusing this thing, and at least to see if I can get close enough to the components to figure out how they're connected and get some component values and stuff, and see if I can do a quick reverse engineer on this. Give me a few minutes. Drink them if you got them. Well, that was some effort. So that was a bit of a challenge to reverse engineer. Not the actual drawing, because this matches the physical layout on the board. There are those rivets that everything is soldered to. So I'm pretty confident in the component layout. But the reverse engineering, I couldn't measure the resistors in circuit because they're in circuit. So I had to recruit my kid and their non-colorblind eyes to help me out. And even they weren't fully confident on a few of the colors, but this makes sense, so we'll go with this. So when it turns on, this capacitor charges through this 125K of resistors and through the light bulb as a very low value resistor to V plus. When that charges up sufficiently, and according to my scope, that's a little under 1.5 volts, then that voltage there is high enough for this voltage divider to allow this transistor to turn on. When this transistor turns on, it gives V minus through a 2K current limiting resistor to the base of the PNP transistor, turning it on and allowing the light to have a path between V plus and V minus. That also discharges this capacitor. Once the capacitor's voltage gets low enough that this guy shuts off, it shuts this guy off, the light goes off, and the capacitor starts charging again for its next cycle. The LDR over here, in the dark, it's a high enough resistance that it's not bothering these guys too much. In the bright light of daytime, it is essentially taking those guys out of the circuit and keeping this voltage low enough that it can never turn on, and it can never turn that guy on, and life is good. At least that's how I figure it. If you have a different interpretation, please drop it down in the comments below and tell me why I'm wrong. But now the important question is, after all this abuse, does it still work? And to my surprise, yes, it does. The other thing that I've noticed is when that LDR does get varying levels of light, it does flash at different rates. So it's mostly dark there, but when I give it just partial light, see, it starts flashing faster. So that's not, it doesn't come completely out of the circuit when it's in the dark, or when it is still impacting that a little bit. It's adding some parallel resistance essentially to this and discharging the capacitor at a different speed. Regardless, I have learned what I wanted to learn. And I hope it's interesting for you guys to see the difference between I think, slightly more modern one that Clive had, although his was also quite old, he said. Although this one, I believe it came into my possession about 35 years ago. Regardless, that's enough rambling. I hope you found that somewhat interesting. I'm going to have a few sips here and wet my throat and then put this thing back together and, finish my drink. Thanks for watching. As always, I do appreciate it. Questions or comments down below. I'll talk to you later.